Hey, you beautiful people, this is Aditi Gupta. I am going to share a part of my life with you today, which is fibromyalgia. A lot of you would not be knowing about fibromyalgia, so I will begin my story, and with time you will understand what fibromyalgia is and why I am creating an entire video about the particular thing. So I was a very meritorious student all my life, until one day after coming from college I was lying down in bed, and out of nowhere sudden pain occurred in my stomach, and I thought, okay, maybe this is because of food poisoning or something very temporary. So I was just waiting for it to pass. But then the pain was not going away. The same midnight I was taken in an ambulance to a hospital where they gave me around 5 to 6 pain injections to subside the pain. The pain never went away. And I came back to my hostel room. I am a student, and I was a student, undergraduate student at the time when it started. So again next day the pain started increasing, and it started moving in the form of a ring from my upper part of the stomach to the lowest part. And then it was about 10 days that the pain was becoming very severe. So I moved to Bangalore. It's one of the city in one of the biggest city in India. And so I moved to Bangalore, where my family stays. So there I went to a very big hospital, and they started checking me for anything, any deficiency or those kind of things. And about 10 days went like that. They checked me for all the minerals, hemoglobin. They checked every organ if it is working properly. They conducted CT scan, MRI, and all sorts of tests. And in the end, they concluded that it's nothing. They did not understand it to be any condition. They could not infer anything wrong going on with my body from all the reports that they received, because all the reports were extraordinarily normal. Usually girls lack hemoglobin, but my hemoglobin was like perfect. It was very good. So then they sent me back to my college, telling that it's all in my head. Maybe it's something that I'm creating, I'm making up in my head. So I was very, very vulnerable at the time. I thought, okay, it started, maybe it's just in my head. Let me go back to my college, and with a fresh perspective, let me start my studies all over again. So I with the strong resolution, I did the same. Started going to classes, appearing for exams, and it was not about a week that I started feeling very dizzy, along with the numbing kind, dull aching kind of pain that I was having all the time, fatigue, low energy. Like about 3 to 4 days after I came back to my college, I started feeling very dizzy and loss of coordination of my body, and I was feeling like I am becoming lifeless. I am becoming half dead from inside, and I didn't know what was going on with me. So it was examination. There were exams about to start in my college. One of my friends took me to a hospital, and the doctor said that I was having very low BP, blood pressure was very low, and other than that everything is normal. So he asked me, it was my first encounter with what low BP feels like. You feel dizziness and all those things, dizziness, loss of coordination, blurredness, and all those things at a time simultaneously. So I was sent home with a lot of apple juices and stuff like that, telling the doctors told me that with some rest you will become normal. So I went home, and after going home I was doing pretty well, other than the pain was there, but the BP low became normal. So then I knew that I have to get back to my studies as soon as possible. I came back to my college, and again the pain now was happening in like pain was in the nature of pain was divided into many ways. Like I was experiencing the dull aching pain all over my body, like somebody has beaten me up very badly with many rods all over my body from head to toe. This was number one kind of pain. And then second number was like many needles were being prickled inside my body everywhere, my hands, my legs, my knees, my forehead, my skin, every part of my skin was feeling like it's being prickled with many needles all the time, 24/7. It would appear and disappear randomly. So then that was second kind of pain. And then third was fatigue. Whenever I used to walk, I used to feel like an elephant, a very big elephant is sitting on my head. And it took a tremendous amount of energy for me to do even brush my teeth or take a bath. So then I started feeling like, started getting this strong feeling that something is terribly wrong with my body. And I wasn't able to do things as I was able to do. I was very energetic prior to all these things when they started. So then I again went home, and I went home and the doctors, I went to many doctors. They could not, all of them kept conducting tests, kept checking me, touching me here and there, seeing. And then they used to, all of them together used to say that it's all in your head, Aditi. There is nothing wrong with you. Either you have had a breakup, or you don't want to study. You are creating mess out of nothing. You want. My professors used to say that let me not get into that. So the gist is that they used to say it's all in my head. It's all in my head. Whatever I'm telling, that I'm experiencing a lot of pain, I'm not able to sleep, I'm feeling dizzy, and I'm all those things, they used to deny that I'm actually having. They said it's nothing. So that point of time, I started Googling my symptoms. And of course, Google says a lot. Even if you have fever and you put your symptoms there, it will say that you have cancer. So that is how Google works. But then with time and with my symptoms, there were many, many other symptoms that started adding to it. Restless leg, and then tinnitus, insomnia, depression, all these kinds of things, migraine, started entering all these things. And with a lot of time, me being my own doctor now, I came across this word fibromyalgia. And then when I tried to cross-check all the symptoms with what I was going through, I was 99% sure that I have fibromyalgia. But then till that time, I did not have a stamp of a doctor saying that I have something, let alone fibromyalgia, but I have anything real. They were not ready to accept it. So then about 18 months passed, I was not heading towards anywhere in my academics. And then I met a doctor in Lucknow, which is another city in India, where where I was frustrated to a point that I had noted every symptom down there, and I gave it to the doctor before he would tell anything. So after looking at the list of symptoms that I was going through, he smiled at me and he was like, Aditi, you know it already. I was like, what? He said, it's fibromyalgia. And that, of course, every patient wants to listen that they don't have anything. But then it was a very, very, I felt like victory that, okay, I already know that it is fibromyalgia, and you saying it in front of people, okay, I have it. But then he said, he explained to me that it's just a syndrome, it's not a disease, and it's not well explained, it's not well understood, it's very rare, and all those things which I had already read on the internet. So he gave me pregabalin 75 mg twice, 150 mg, which I took for around 3 months. It did not help me. And I came back to college. I went to another place where the doctor, with the failure of pregabalin helping me, he gave me duloxetine, which is also called Cymbalta, I think. So I was very intolerant to duloxetine. After about 2 to 3 days only, I was getting tremors in night and vomiting and itching all over my body. I had to stop duloxetine. And then many other medicines also were given by many doctors, rheumatologists from many parts of India, like Ultraset Savila, and then many other antidepressants too. But all of these medicines never worked, and they only succeeded in making the symptoms worse. So then about 6 to 12 months, I stopped taking any medicine because the medicines were doing no good thing. They were not helping me. So during that time, I knew that I have fibromyalgia, but I also read that there are many alternative treatments like acupuncture, massage therapy, and also I noticed that when I'm happy, I feel the pain less. When I'm stressed, when people are blaming me for whatever I'm going through, it used to get to a point that I wasn't mobile all the time. So then I tried all these things one by one, the acupuncture, massage therapy, yoga, CBT, and then I kept doing all these things. But it's been now 4 years. It all started at the age of 19, when I was 19, and I am 23 now. It's 23 and a half years old, and it is about 4.5 years, half year, the fibromyalgia, me experiencing fibromyalgia, it's been 4.5 years old. Now I have entered into a line of treatment called homeopathy. It derives from a German medicine. I'm taking that. Again, there is no success in it, but they say it takes a lot of time for it to work. So I'm still positive, as I was always, but I undergo a tremendous amount of pain all the time, from headache to throbbing kind of pain, stabbing kind of pain, and then me being immobile, weakness, dizziness, and then brain fog. And because of all those conditions, I am still stuck at my undergraduation. I have undergone emotional abuse and all those kind of things by my own circumstances. For a very long time, I kept blaming myself when it was not diagnosed, and I have undergone trauma because of all those things. Now I know that it is fibromyalgia. Now I know that Lady Gaga, Morgan Freeman, and many of you who are reading this, because I'm going to share this video primarily on support groups of fibromyalgia, and also put it on YouTube for whoever is seeking the stamp. Like once I was seeking that I have fibromyalgia, I used to surf the entire internet for someone from India who has fibromyalgia and who is vocal about it. So there are not many people who are doing it. So maybe I think it is a great way to share my stories, though it does not have a happy ending yet. But then I am here to share whatever you are going through, and I will help you in whichever way I think I can. So that's what through all these years, there was one time when I was ready to kill myself because of the pain. And the suicide rate in fibromyalgia is too high. But I all through this time, only positivity has kept me going. There is nothing great going on in my life except me finding solace in reading and writing. I have my own blog called calminsights.com, where I try to spread positivity by my writings. You can go to calminsights.com. Insights is INSIGHTS. Calm is CALM, calminsights.com, and read writings by me. And that's all pretty much that I do. I used to travel a lot all through these years, 4 years, but now the pain is progressive. All the symptoms of fibromyalgia is progressive. Though I am looking very normal to you, but I'm undergoing tremendous amount of pain, excruciating pain in my back, in my head, in my eyes, everywhere. So that is why fibromyalgia is very hard to diagnose. That's what I'm on. Only positivity has kept me going, and it's that's what I try to keep myself with, no matter how bad the conditions are, circumstances be. So please let me know your feelings, your own story, or however you feel. And this video is solely to raise awareness about fibromyalgia. Fibromyalgia is not very understood. Some say it is a central nervous system disorder. Some say there is a problem in blood vessels. some say something and some say it is not real, but then it is a real disease. There is even if for those of you who don't have fibromyalgia and who say, okay, this girl looks very normal, she is doing it just for fun, just to get attention. So I am giving you an open challenge that the pain that I am undergoing, if artificially it is given to you just for 1 hour, you'll freak out like anything. So please be more patient, more kind towards people who tell you that there's something wrong and it is not visible. So that's what is for today. Thank you for watching.